Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, you'll cover grading using the new manager view in Flame 2020. The manager is a much more simplified way of working with some of Flame's tools. And whether you're a beginner or an experienced Flame artist, the manager will allow you to access a whole range of functionality without digging deep into the node flow graph. As I mentioned earlier, this video will show the manager in the context of grading, and other videos will cover the manager in the context of compositing and rotoscoping. If you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the video podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. So to start off the grading example, load the downloaded media and open it as a sequence. You'll be using the image toolset, which is available as a timeline effects in an edit, or a node in a compositing flow graph. The functionality is identical once you're looking at the tools. In this example, you can select the segment in the sequence and click the Effects tab to switch to the effects environment. Now, to the left of the viewport is the media panel for media management tasks. This is not to be confused with the manager, so hide the media panel using either the pull-down menu or press Shift Escape. Now, the manager is displayed through a viewport, so switch to a 2-up view with Alt 2. If you don't see the manager in the view, click the viewing pull-down menu and choose Manager. This can also be changed by pressing 8. The manager displays all the objects in this tool, as well as their processing pipelines involving selectives and selective effects like the master grade. Simply by choosing them in the manager, it's very easy to switch between all the different tools. For example, you can select the primary master grade and change the overall look of the image. Next to each of the objects in the manager, you can toggle them on and off to see a before and after result. Now, for any reason, you may want to rename an object, just click on it once and you can edit the text box. For example, I'll change this master grade to base grade. So it's quick and easy to choose an object and adjust its properties. In addition to muting objects in the manager, you also have access to a variety of functions, such as blend modes, transparencies, and the overall effect of a selective effects. All these exposed options are incredibly useful for grading, compositing, and rotoscoping. Now, some of the objects have a triangle, which allows you to expand or collapse any tools or pipelines associated with that object. So the primary object has a master grade selective effects, and so does the selective object above it. These collapsible states should help you with managing the tools, as well as keeping the manager neat and tidy. Continuing with the example, after applying a base grade, you wish to work on some secondary grading. The first selective is already available by default, and a master grade selective effects is associated with this selective. In terms of a typical workflow, you would first isolate a part of your image and then grade through the selective. So let's use a G-mask to brighten up the area around the car. Calling up the contextual menu over the selective in the manager, you get the exact same options as the HUD or selective manager. Choose Add G-mask link and choose one of the many options. Now draw your G-mask to isolate the portion of the image. And then use the contextual menu to add a gradient point and feather the edge of the mask. When you look back at the manager, you will see a G-mask section appear under the selective object, and this tells you what is associated with the selective. You can now perform your grade, and the selective will limit the master grade to the G-mask. You can obviously key in isolation, use 3D AOVs, or even combine them with a G-mask to create a very precise secondary grade. However, since the G-mask is a physical object, it will be displayed in the manager, unlike the keyer, which is built into the selective object. So you can choose to either display all these components or hide them within the manager. Now, as in the previous versions of Flame, you can have multiple selectives for grading and VFX development, as well as multiple selective effects within each selective. You can add them through the viewport HUD, Selective Manager, or even click the plus tab in the active selective. This is the same for the manager. So let's develop the colors and light that come from the sky. You call up the contextual menu over the image object and choose to add a new selective with the master grade. Raise the lift value, drop the offset, and apply a yellowish tint to the shot. To control where the colors affect the image, let's add some G-masks. Call up the contextual menu and add a plane-based spline to the selective. Now rotate it into position at the top left corner of the frame. Next, apply a gradient point and drag out a wide gradient to control the intensity of the selective. You can create multiple masks to control the selective, and this can all be displayed within the manager. Add another G-mask to the same selective and draw it over the trees to the right of the car. As before, soften the edge with another gradient point. So the manager will display all the objects used in the grading workflow, and their tools are accessed with a quick click. Now I'd like to point out that the manager shows the order of the selectives and their shader pipelines. This uses a top-down priority. So the primary grade is at the bottom and the selective stack on top. To rearrange the objects, you can just click and drag them in the manager. There is no need to use the priority editor. In addition to that, you can also rearrange the shader pipeline within each selective directly within the manager. To demonstrate this, let's complete our example with a blooming effect on the last selective. Call up the contextual menu and choose to add another selective effects. At the bottom of the list, choose the bloom selective effects. Now decreasing the threshold, you can see that the blooming is affecting the result of the first master grade on the current selective. This effect is burning the image rather than blooming it. So to apply the blooming selective effects before the master grade, go to the manager and drag the master grade selective effects above the blooming selective effects. This changes the order of the effects in the selective, and the result is much more pleasing. You can toggle the individual selective effects on and off to make comparisons with and without the effects or grading. Now realistically, the G-masks need to be tracked to complete this example, but you can do that in your own time and all with the manager. Hopefully, this has given you a good understanding how beneficial the manager can be with grading and look development. If you're also interested in seeing the manager working in a compositing or rotoscoping scenario, please watch the other videos about the manager. Don't forget to also check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2020. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.